You know, aphids have some very special characteristics. They breed like rabbits, they do little else, and they don't move much. In other words, they have very high nitrogen requirement, and they don't need very much carbohydrate for energy since they don't move. So what do? They feed on plant juices. Plant juices are notoriously poor in nitrogen. So they have to pump an enormous amount of plant juices through their body to get enough nitrogen, and they end up with excess carbohydrate. So little droplets come out their rear, which are rich in sugar. So guess what? They buy themselves the service of mercenaries with that currency. Ants come in, drink these droplets, in return guard the aphids. So you have a real symbiotic relationship going on here. I got interested in a population of aphids, a kind of aphid called a woolly aphid, because they have this fluffy, waxy material on the surface. They look like little sheep. And I was photographing them, and I also collected the wax, which turned out to be an interesting story because it's practically a pure compound, which is rare in nature. But I was photographing the aphids, looking through the camera, and suddenly I saw an aphid run through the field. I said, what's going on here? Aphids can't run. So I looked closely, and it wasn't an aphid at all. It was an aphid eater, dressed as an aphid, literally. It was the larva of something called a green lacewing, a completely isolated group of insects called the Neuroptera, have a family, I think it is, called the Chrysopidae, which includes the green lacewings. The larvae are aphid eaters. But this particular beast was eating the aphids, plucking the wool, the waxy, fluffy material off the back of the aphids, and putting it on its own back. And guess what? The ants, the shepherds, were confusing it with a sheep. So you had literally a wolf in sheep's clothing, dressed as an aphid, feeding on the aphids. But the story didn't end there. It got incredibly complicated and interesting. One of the offenders that the ants were protecting the aphids against were wasps. They are foraging wasps, which were also interested in the honeydew. And the ants were, of course, not willing to share it with the wasps. So the wasps were being chased away. So I found out that the wasps caught on to the fact that the drippings of the extra honeydew, which were collecting on branches lower on the plant, were accessible in that way. But let me tell you how complicated it became. There's a fungus that grows in association with that aphid colony, which lives on the drippings of the aphid colony. The wasps go down to the fungus, squeeze the fungus out to get the juice, since they can't get the real stuff from the ants, from the aphids up above. On top of that, there's a carnivorous caterpillar living in the aphids. Caterpillars feed on plants. There are very few caterpillars that are carnivorous. Well, this particular one is specialized to feed on the aphids and lives under the aphids with a shield of silk between itself and the aphids. So the ants are unaware of the fact that there is an aphid eater hidden beneath the aphids. You see, if you're going to feed on aphids, you've got to be protected against ants. The ants are that good. The wolf in sheep's clothing dresses itself up as an aphid. The caterpillar lives under a mat of silk that shields it from the ants above. And there are also fly larvae that feed on the aphids. They're flies called surfeit flies. They're characteristic in their flight. They hover when you see them. Well, their larvae feed on aphids and are protected against the aphids. How? They have a salivary material which hardens like a glue. So when they're attacked by an ant, they vomit on the ant, a tiny little droplet, which immediately hardens like rubber cement, entangling the ant. If the ant touches another ant, the two ants become stuck together. So you have this whole microcosm there. The focus is on the aphids with their excess honeydew, which buys the ants, which protects the aphids, which necessitates any aphid eater to take guard against the ants.